Now in this lecture, we will know about the second normal form, that is 2NF. It's again a type of a normalization. What exact the normalization is? That one is we just do when we create any table under the database, and in a particular table it contains multiple columns, and we again normalize it with the one table divided into the maybe the two table to reduce the redundancy of the data, and also for the insertion, deletion and updation anomalies. That's why we do the normalization, right? That one is simply the definition of normalization. Now we will know about the second normal form, that is 2NF. It must satisfy the two conditions. If the particular given table, we have a particular one table, that table satisfy the these two conditions. That one is after that we can say that the given table is in a 2NF. Table should be in a first normal form. In a given table should be in a 1NF. In 1NF. What exact the rule for 1NF? We can say that the important rule for 1NF, not a particular record contains some multiple values. Multiple values like C, C++ as a subject under the student 1, student name, student mobile. Right? Then C++ as a subject, it's a multi-value. Then mobile number, mobile 1 and mobile 2. Means a single record contains the multi-value attributes. That one is not be a part of a 1NF. If we remove it, then the table is in a 1NF. Then second rule, there should be a no partial dependency. Now we will need to know about the partial dependency means what, and that one is not comes with a given table with a partial dependency. Then and then we can say that the given table is in a 2NF. Now we need to know about the partial dependency means what. What is partial dependency? We need to know about first that what exactly the dependency. Now what is the dependency? Let's take an example. Student is table. This one is a table, student table. Now it contains a ID, name, registration number, branch and address. Now the particular it contains a record. If we go with this table, it's not it's in a 1NF because of not attribute run with the multi-valued, right? Like CS and IT, it is not in a 1NF, but now it is in a 1NF. Then what exact the dependency is? In a given table, primary key is the student ID, right? Now the if we want to find out the record from the table, if we search with the student ID, we can easily get the unique record of a, with the help of the student ID. Now the table in the column or group of column which can uniquely identify the each record in a table, it's a primary key. It may be the single column name or it may be is a group of a column name. We can easily find out the unique record. We know student ID, we can easily fetch the correct record. Now the condition, that one is I can ask from the branch name of a student with the student ID. I can get it easily. That is a branch name of the student with the student ID. It shows the unique record, right? Because of the student ID. If I ask the student name with the student ID, that one is also with we can get it the unique record. So all I need in a student ID and every other column depend on it, we can say that, or with the help of that, or we can be a fetched using it. Without student ID, we cannot get the unique record. That's why we can say that dependency, this is the dependency, the other columns which one is depend on the student ID, that is the dependency, and it's also called the functional dependency. how I exact the functional when we apply any function related to update the name of the student, of a student ID is Stain, then definitely the name of the student is dependent on the student ID. That's why updation function dependency is dependent on the primary key. That's why it's called as a dependency. Then what exact the partial dependency is? It's a full dependency because of the all the columns is depend on this student ID. Now what is the partial dependency? That one is simply we create one more table, that is the subject table, which is subject ID and the subject name. This one is a student table, it contains the student information. Now student table contains the record with the subject ID as a primary key. Now again we create a third table, that one is a table as name as a score, that it contains a score ID as a primary key, then student ID, subject ID, marks and teachers. That teacher is related to the subject ID because of the subject, which is subject is related to a which teacher. This is again a third table which one is showing that the detail about the subject marks related to the student, and again that subject related to the teacher. Now score table, we are saving the student ID to know which student marks are these, and subject ID to know for which subject the marks are. Means why we need a score ID? Because of we need to uniquely find out the record of a particular score of a student. Again, it needs a subject ID also because of we need to know about which student in a which subject get how many marks. That's why the subject ID, student ID is important. And all the combination of student ID, subject ID, it's reflect with the score ID, right? Know about which subject of the marks. That's why subject ID is important. Then together student ID and subject ID form a candidate key for this table. Student ID and subject ID form a candidate key, which can be a primary key, which can be a primary key. Why? Because of how this combination can be a primary key, is not a candidate key, because of with the help of student ID and subject ID, we get the marks of a particular subject, right? That's why we need to know about to get the subject marks of a student ID. We cannot get it without the student subject ID, because of the student ID with which subject it gets the marks. That's why student ID and subject ID is important to get the marks of a particular subject and for particular student. That's why the primary key, we can say that the student ID and subject ID is a primary key. Now student ID 10 can get it from this table? No. If I ask you to get me the marks of a student with the student ID, if we go with only the student ID, we run with the confusion, that is the student ID have again the two marks, then which marks if we call the 10 as a student ID, it have the two record, 70 or 75, then out of these two, which record we required, which subject marks we required, then we need to know about the subject ID also. That's why the subject ID you would not know for which student. Student ID and subject ID to uniquely identify any row. With the help of this two, it uniquely identify the row, which one is 70 or 75. If we know the 10 and the subject ID is 2, then it easily get this row. But if we only run with the student ID, it confusion between these two row, 70 or 75, right? It's a Java subject marks or the C++ marks. Then it need to know about the combination of student ID and subject ID, and then it get the unique record. This is the one scenario. Now, but where is a partial dependency? Now we have a column name as a teacher. which is only depend on a subject. If we go with the this is the primary key, student ID plus subject ID, which returns the unique record, unique rule. But if we know about the teacher, that teacher is only related to the subject ID, is not related to a student ID, then as a considering student ID and the subject ID is a primary key, student ID and subject ID is a primary key, is a student ID plus subject ID whole as considering as a primary key, because of without that we cannot get the exact subject marks, is a primary key. Then teacher field, teacher ID or teacher, that is a teacher, is only depend on a subject ID, is because of teacher is only related to a subject, it's not related to a student, right? Now out of this primary key, teacher field is only depend on this subject ID, is not totally depend on the both, is not totally depend on the both. That's why we can say that it's a partially dependent, it's a partially dependent, is not totally depend on this primary key, and that is comes concept comes is a partial dependency, right? Which one is comes with this table, partially dependency, because of if we only get the primary key as a student ID, we cannot identify the unique record. If we consider student ID and the subject ID as a primary key, then the particular teacher is only a depend on a subject ID, it is not totally depend on the both ID, or it may be a not totally depend on the primary key. And the 2ANF says that whatever the attribute which one is totally depend on the primary key, it's totally depend on the primary key. That's why we need to resolve this table. It's not in a 2NF, it is in a 1NF, right? Every record have a unique atomic value. It's a in a 1NF, but it's not in a 2NF, because of this teacher is partially depend on the particular primary key. It's a, we can say that partially depend, it's not fully depend. That's why it's not in a 2NF. Now what is the solution? How to remove the partial dependency? Now we create the divide that table, that is subject ID, subject name and the teacher. Means we just to remove the teacher from the score table and add it in a subject table, right? Add it in a subject table. Then it's a clear out the dependency, that is score ID, student ID, subject ID and marks. It remove the teacher and add in a subject table. Now we can say that it remove the partial dependency from the table, and it's, we can say that it's a fully depend on a primary key. That is a concept. It's a subject ID, consider as subject ID as a primary key. Definitely subject is related to a subject name, and we can say that teacher is depend on a subject ID. It's a fully depend, it's not partially. Same thing, marks, that one is a fully depend on marks of student of the subject, of a particular subject. That's why we can say that it's a fully depend, it's not partially depend. This is simply the explanation about the 2NF, and 2NF have a rule, that is it is in a 1NF, and second, it there should not be a there should be a no partial dependency, okay? That is a full dependency on a particular primary key. That is the rule or condition. The given table is in a second normal form. Thank you.